Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Wang, the host of Making Sense of Science channel. Immunotherapy is revolutionizing current cancer care and transforming oncology practice around the world. Today, immunotherapy is available to treat more than 15 types of cancer, and this novel therapy even led to a remission for the former President Jimmy Carter's metastatic brain tumor. Dr. Steven Rosenberg, Chief of Surgery at the National Cancer Institute, NIH, is regarded as the father of cancer immunotherapy, as he pioneered development of the first immunotherapy that's effective for advanced cancer. If you want to understand what the immunotherapy is, how it works, and who will benefit from it, join me at this interview with Dr. Rosenberg to hear his personal explanation on all of those questions. Dr. Rosenberg, you were trained as a surgeon, but why did you start to pursue the non-surgical research field of immunotherapy in the 1970s?
So I've known ever since I was young that I wanted to get into doing research, and went to medical school at Johns Hopkins. And after a year of internship, actually went and got a Ph.D. for 4 years in biophysics at Harvard before coming back and finishing the residency. I knew I wanted to get a good science education so that I could do research. And as a surgical resident, you see a lot of patients with cancer and you operate on them and you feel good coming out of the operating room, and yet almost half of people will then go on to recur with disease elsewhere, what we call metastatic disease. And so it's clear that surgery is not enough. We have three good ways to treat cancer: surgery, radiation, chemotherapy, and still last year 600,000 Americans died of the disease. So we desperately need new approaches, and immunotherapy caught my eye early on as an area of research that was likely to be profitable in terms of finding new treatments, and it has been.
What are the approaches of immunotherapy, and how does the cancer immunotherapy work?
I've been emphasizing for the last several decades a different kind of approach to immunotherapy, and that is taking advantage of the body's own natural immune defenses to treat the disease. Now, the major body defense against disease, generally infectious diseases, is the immune system, and it's the lymphocytes, the white blood cells that circulate in the body. There are about 1 million of them for every thimbleful of blood. They're the warriors of the body. They recognize what is not normal in the body and can recognize and attack it. Now, the immune system can find a cancer as different than normal and raise an immune reaction against it, these lymphocytes, but they're too weak to keep the cancer from growing.
Then what did you do to strengthen the weak immune cells so that they can fight cancers more effectively?
The approach that I've taken has been referred to as adoptive cell therapy, where you isolate the lymphocytes, these immune warriors that can recognize the cancer. You further educate them or genetically engineer them outside the body in the laboratory, and then grow them to large amounts and return them to the patient under appropriate conditions. And the first time that was ever done was our studies in 1988. We then performed the first studies of the genetic engineering of lymphocytes, that is, inserting new genes into lymphocytes to create cells that never existed before in the course of evolution. And that ultimately led to CAR T cells. We were the first to treat successfully a patient with CAR T cells in 2009, now being offered to thousands of individuals around the country and, in fact, in the world as well.
What types of cancer are benefiting from the immunotherapy? How well has it improved cancer treatment outcomes so far?
Right now, almost half of all patients with the most aggressive of the lymphomas, the diffuse large B-cell lymphomas, as well as children with acute lymphocytic leukemia, we can get response rates near 70-80% with durable, complete elimination of all of the cancer in about half of patients. So it represents, I think, an important step for those patients. We now need to learn how to apply that same principle to the solid cancers that are the big killers.
Thank you, Dr. Rosenberg, for explaining the nature and the features of immunotherapy to us today.
Sure. Well, it's my pleasure.
To watch the second part of this interview, subscribe to our channel now so you won't miss it. I'm Dr. Michael Wang. Thank you for watching and see you next time.